Well, it's been an extraordinary rally, Brian. But you got to think about it. When you get a rotation out of large caps and into small caps, the size difference is so much different. Remember, it was only 6 months ago that Apple was larger than the entire Russell 2000. So you get even 1% of assets going out of the S&P 500 and into the small caps. It's going to cause a big move. And you tend to see this early in the early stages of bull markets. So there's only been one other time when you've seen the Russell double within a year off of its closing low in the past year. And that was coming out of the 82 bull market. And so in June of 83. The other time where it came quite close, but not quite 100%, was coming out of the financial crisis from March 2009 to March 2010. So this is truly a rally of historic proportions for the Russell 2000. And, then the question is, what now? What do we focus on now? So just for history as a guide here.
Buddy, I love you. Nobody provides better historical context than you. But like the ghost of Christmas future, I want to know what's going to happen, not what has happened. Where do you see it going from here?
Well, so for starters, what we do is we look back and then we take some factors into account. So coming out of the 82, first year of the 82 bull market, we saw small caps decline 20% after that initial doubling over the course of the next year. In March 2009, we saw the complete opposite happen. You saw from March 2010 out a year, the Russell 2000 gained over 20%. So again, that doesn't really tell you much. But what we have to focus on here is small caps are trading at very high valuations right now, the Russell 2000 as a whole. But when you start getting into individual stocks in the index, you can find better opportunities. So the Russell 2000's PE is negative right now, but that's because most of the companies in the index don't have earnings. If you look at and focus only at the companies that have earnings, though, they actually trade cheaper than comparable large cap names, which also have earnings. So the S&P 500 PE ratio of companies with positive earnings is actually higher than the comparable group of small cap stocks that have earnings. But for the index as a whole, it's lofty. So this goes to our theme that we've been talking about for several months now, most of this year, is a move away from indexing and towards individual stocks. Because within the Russell 2000, you're going to get a lot of, if you buy the ETF, you're going to get a lot of garbage.